These days, we do our banking online, our shopping online, and even our dating online.
The government even allows us to lodge secure tax returns online and wants us to keep sensitive e-health records there too. You can even enrol to vote using the internet. So why is it on election day that every Australian adult has to join long queues at primary schools or even use snail mail just to cast our vote?
Electronic voting could mean we get real-time election results rather than waiting till the polls close. Recounts or audits could be done at the push of a button. It could mean the end of absentee voting, those ridiculously giant ballot papers, even the army of employees manning polling stations around the country. There's basically two types of electronic voting: e-voting, where you use a machine at a polling booth, or i-voting, where you remotely vote via the internet. 30 countries have used e-voting machines for binding political elections. Of the 30, 11 currently use them, and only 3 use them for the entire electorate. In all, the attitude in Europe and North America remains sceptical, whereas the technology is increasingly embraced in South America and in Asia.
But secure, private and verifiable electronic voting remains an elusive and controversial topic.
The 2006 Emmy-nominated HBO documentary Hacking Democracy highlighted alleged e-vote tampering in the 2000 and 2004 US presidential elections.
This is terrible. We can't count our votes. So how do we know this is right?
One study claimed that George Bush got 260,000 more votes in key Florida counties than he should have, which some say affected the outcome. Critics cite many documented glitches, flaws, freezes, and irregularities that have plagued e-voting over the last decade. Fears of cyber attacks remain. Just last year, 36 million euros were stolen via malware from so-called secure bank accounts. If elections were targeted like that, the damage to the democratic process could be catastrophic.
For the Australian Electoral Commission, the risks still outweigh the benefits. One official paper even says the prevailing attitude is, if it ain't broke, why fix it?
A trial in last year's New South Wales state election got over 46,000 votes, but a bug was said to have rendered 43 votes corrupt. The same system will be used again in 2015, offering limited i-voting for the blind, illiterate and disabled in New South Wales, even for absentee voters or those more than 20 kilometres away from a polling place. Federally, the AEC told The Feed they will release a discussion paper later this year about online voting. While the AEC itself does not have a position in relation to online voting, it would welcome the discussion.
Despite the risks with electronic voting, the government's quite happy to have other crucial civic functions carried out online, even using the same technology. Given that the AEC doesn't have an official position on electronic voting, while our government might change on September 7 like that, change to the voting process certainly won't.